Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve problem 14-32 that is taken from chapter number 14, Energy Methods, and book name is Mechanics of Material by R.C. Hibbeler. So statement is determine the slope at point A of the beam. EI is constant. So you can see this is the beam having a roller support at point B and there is a pin support at point C. And at point A, there is external movement M0. Clear? So you due to this movement, you have there will be bending stress. So you have to find the slope of point A. And due to this movement, this beam will bend like this. So this will be the slope of point A. So let's start with the solution. So the what we will use is we will use conservation of energy. Conservation of energy, which is that strain energy due to external movement is equal to strain energy due to bending. So due to this movement M0, the external strain energy will be equal to 1 over 2 M0 into theta A, and theta A will be the slope of that point A. Let's say this beam will bend like this. So this will be the theta A. So you have to find theta A and this will be the strain energy due to bending. Now what we will do is that for strain energy in bending, we will first find this. How you will find this? So we will do is that first we will find this reaction forces. If you remove this roller support at point B, so you will be having a vertical reaction force which will be RB, and there will be a vertical reaction in downward direction at point C, and this will be RC. So we will find this RB and RC by using equation of equilibrium. So first equation of equilibrium is that sum of all moment about point B is equal to zero, taking the counterclockwise moment as positive. So about point B, the first moment is M0, which is counterclockwise, so it will be plus. So I will write M0. The second moment due to point B due to RC will be RC into perpendicular distance A, and that will be clockwise, so it will be negative. So I will write minus RC multiplied by A is equal to 0. So from here, we will get RC will be equal to M0 divided by A. So this is the reaction force that this pin supports upper on beam. Now we'll find this RB by using sum of all forces along Y direction must be equal to zero, and upward force is taken as positive. So you can see RB is upward minus RC, which is M0 by A, and that their sum must be equal to zero. So from here, RB will be also equal to M0 divided by A. So both values are positive. So it means that our assumed direction that RB is upward and RC is downward is correct. Now, the next step is that we have this reaction force. So what we will do is that we will cut the beam between A and B for region AB. So it means that X is greater than 0 and less than A. So this will be your X. So if I draw the free body diagram of this beam, so it will be like this. So at this is point A, where you have only external movement M0, and this is distance X. So if you cut it, you will be having a shear force and you will be having a movement M. Clear? So how we'll find this? So we'll find this by using sum of all forces. Let this is your point one. Sum of all forces about movement about point one is equal to zero, and taking the counterclockwise movement as positive. So you can see M0, which is counterclockwise, and M is also counterclockwise, is their sum must be equal to zero. It means that reaction force is equal to minus M0. What does it mean? It means that our assumed direction that this movement is counterclockwise is wrong. It should be in clockwise direction. Next step is that we will do is for region for region C onward. C onward. And again, what you will do is you cut the beam. This will be your X. That this is your X1. Clear? So this will be X1. And this will be for region X2. So what we will do is that when you cut the beam over here, so this is the beam and this is X2. So you can see when you cut it, you will be having a shear force and you will be having a moment. Let this is 0.2. So how you will find this external moment? By using sum of all moment about 0.2 is equal to 0 and taking the counterclockwise moment as positive. So M, which is clockwise, so minus M, there is no other moment, is equal to 0. So it means that this moment is equal to 0 for the region X is, X2 is, I will write X2 is greater than or equal to 0 and less or equal to A. Now the third step is that if you cut this beam at this point, clear, and let this is X3. X3 start from C, this is X3. So for region CB, X3 is greater than or equal to 0 and less or equal to A. So when you cut this and draw the free body diagram of the beam, so it will be like this. This is your point C where you have RC, and RC value is M0 by A. And this is distance X3. So when you cut it, you will be having a shear force and you will be having a moment. Let this is your point 3. So we are going to find out this moment by using sum of all moment about point 3 is equal to 0 and taking the counterclockwise moment as positive. So about point 3, one moment is this M, which is clockwise, and this will be minus M. So minus M. And the second moment about point 3 is due to this M naught into A, and perpendicular distance is X3. And this is also clockwise. So minus M naught over A into 3 is equal to X3, not 3. X3 is equal to 0. So it means that this moment M is equal to minus M naught X3 over A. Clear? And this sign negatives mean that our assumed direction is wrong. So it should be in counterclockwise direction. Now we have all three moment for the region. So what we will do is that we will get this UI, strain energy due to bending, and this strain energy due to bending, we know that this is equal to, for whole beam 0 to L, this is the general equation, M square dx over 2EI. For three region, I will divide it as EI is constant, so I will take EI outside. And we will have integral from 0 to A minus M naught in M naught square into dx1. This is for region AB. Plus again integral from 0 to A, and for second one we have this minus M, which is 0. So 0 square into dx2. Plus integral from 0 to A, and the third one was this one, minus M naught X3 divided by A whole square dx3. And we will close the square bracket. So from here, UI strain energy due to bending is equal to 1 over 2 EI, and this will give you minus M naught square X, and limit will be from 0 to A. Clear? Plus this will give you 0, and this will give you minus M naught plus M naught square over A square into X3 square. So integral of X3 square will be X3 cube divided by 3, and limit from 0 to A. Clear? And if you further simplify it, 1 over 2 EI into this will be also plus. This will be m naught square a plus 0 plus m naught square over 3a into a cube. Okay, this is a square. That will give you strain energy due to bending. So 1 over 2ei into m naught square a plus m naught square a over 3. Clear? And if you take the LCM, that will give you 3, 3, and there is 1 over here. So 3 is divided by 1 is 3. So 3 m naught square a plus m naught square a. Clear? And that will give you 4 m naught square a over 3 multiplied by 1 over 2 e I. So that will give you 2 m naught square a over 3. That will be the strain energy due to bending. Now we will use this equation, conservation of energy. So I will write 1 over 2 m naught into theta a is equal to 2 m naught square a over 3. Because we have said that strain energy due to external work is equal to strain energy due to bending. Clear? So from here, this theta a, which is slope at point A, will be equal to 4 times m naught a over 3 e I. Why? Because there is a 3 e I as well. Clear? So here 3 e I. And you can see this is the answer of our this question. And that was all about this problem 14-32. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Also share my videos with your friends and help me in growing further. Thank you for watching.